Let me start today with a small story, you know, and that story is about a bird which was staying on a tree, a sparrow. The family was staying there, and what happened was a hurricane came, so everything got disturbed. Now the kid of that sparrow, you know, also got lost, and it went and settled where a hen was also having its own kid. So it was growing up, you know, and every day it was watching the birds in the sky flying, and there was a desire and a need to fly. But the sparrow's kid had watched the hen fly, and the hen would fly a little above the earth. So, you know, it also thought that I will also be able to fly only this much. It did try one or two times, you know, to probably go at a higher length up. But somewhere, you know what happened, there was a fear that came inside. That what if I fail, and you know, everybody will laugh at me. So it did not give its full effort. This went on for quite a while. One day somebody, you know, observed that between the hen's kids there is also a sparrow kid which is going about. So what he did, he lifted the sparrow kid and took it up right on a mountain tip, and from there, you know, pushed the through the sparrow kid into the air. At first, you know, there was a feeling that it is going to fall down, but there is an innate intelligence. So, you know, the sparrow also over a period of time was fluttering the wings, and the sparrow found that it is able to fly. Somewhere I feel that this story relates a lot to our homeopathic practice. We are all like sparrow kids which have been brought up by a hen, you know, and we feel that the flight is what we are capable is very limited. I am going to present to you today possibilities. Possibility that is going to give you freedom. Possibility that is going to help you emancipate or liberate. What is the freedom or you know, liberation that I am talking of? And is it that everybody has been talking of a lot in homeopathic field? So is there something that probably has been missed out? I feel yes. Somewhere we are not performing to the capacities that probably homeopathy and homeopaths are capable of achieving. Let's see what am I talking of. See, mine is like a parachute. It functions only when open. So I suggest that you allow yourself that flight and that freedom for at least 5 to 6 hours. I always feel, you know, that Hanuman was very sure of what he is written in Organon. One of the things that he talks of is the highest ideal of cure is rapid, gentle and permanent. We always talk of homeopathy being gentle and permanent, but we never talk of homeopathy being rapid. Hardly we have seen, you know, in our own personal experiences or even whatever has been talked of in literature for, you know, so much years together, that there has been hardly any reference on the rapidity part of homeopathy. I want to show you this aspect of it. And I feel that homeopathy is capable of giving rapid cures. That's why I took up that homeopathy achieves rapid response in advanced pathology. Whatever you are going to view here are those type of cases which probably have created a mental block in us. Let's see the first case. Now this is a case you could probably, is it readable? Yeah. Which came with a complaint of heaviness of head, right frontal, right eyelid pain, right side nose pain of a lady of 54 years, diplopia, squint, right eye. MRI was done in March 2004, which showed swelling, SOL in right frontal region, most likely to be of infective origin. Probable diagnosis was tuberculoma, sarcoidosis or a rare lymphoma. And she had gone for an allopathic treatment, but since they had nothing to offer, you know, she refused any further treatment. We started homeopathic treatment on 18-4-04. On 3-5-04, headache was right side better by 50%. And you can see subsequently, in a span of April to June, the MRI shows significant reduction in the swelling on the right frontal region. This was before treatment MRI, and this is an after treatment MRI. This was in a span of 2 months that we find significant reduction in the swelling. Not only that, but even in the symptoms. This is another case of a 2.5-year-old baby. She presented with red urine, no pain, no burning, quantity of urine normal. Urine is almost blood red during attacks of cold and cough, puffiness around the eyes. Was diagnosed as post-viral glomerular nephritis at Jaslok Hospital. She was started steroid on July 2002. After a month of steroids, the reports are, you know, as per what it was. So then they were suggesting that they had to go for biopsy. On a 2 months trial of steroid, patient showed poor response, so she resorted to homeopathic treatment. Now the treatment was started on 7-8-2002. Steroids were stopped on 2-8. A week before starting homeopathic treatment, steroids were stopped because they were asking for further investigations. This is the urine report analysis, which shows that we started treatment on 7-8-02. On 8-8, see the albumin percentage. It shows 800 milligram percentage. RBCs were 250 to 300. That's an alarming, you know, report. On 12-8, we came down to seeing that the albumin has risen to 1,100, and RBCs also had gone to more than 500. Between 8-8 to 28-12, that means around 4 months of homeopathic treatment, you can see that there has been a systematic and a progressive downfall in the albumin levels as well as the RBC levels.